such breathtaking beauty. When I was little, I'd never been able to source. So high, but travel so far.
We will reach the most distant stars.
And right now...
Wow, science is amazing. The power of the polymers is incredible.
Sailor or astronomer, with a thought device, you can train for any profession in no time.
Major Nechayev reporting for duty on Comrade Sechenov's direct order.
Welcome, Comrade Major. Today is a joyful occasion. The birthday of Collective.
Yeah, many happy returns. Cut to the chase, would you? I've got places to be.
Naturally. This is the future of Soviet education. A personal project of Dr. Sechenov's poly-education. Gone are the days when Soviet citizens had to spend years studying at educational institutions. From this moment on, just inject a special neuropolymer encoded with the education you want, a university-level natural sciences curriculum, for example, and you'll instantly become an educated member of society. Want to learn Korean? Or get a doctorate in nuclear physics? Or learn to play the piano? With Collective 2.0, you can!
Yeah, been there, done that. Skip the foreplay, bot.
Excuse me, of course! Your particular case definitely calls for something more efficacious. Nevertheless, you will still need an initial neuropolymer injection. Comrade Sechenov is expecting you, Agent P3. I've been informed of your imminent arrival. Here, take this capsule. Upgraded your glove with scanner functionality. Using the neuropolymer as a conduit, the sensors in your glove are now directly connected to your neural system, especially your eyes' polymer retina. To activate the scanner, just make a special gesture. Please choose an object of interest and extend your arm toward it. The palm of your hand should be facing the object. Contract all the fingers on your hand, except for your thumb and index finger. Extend your thumb and index finger to form a right angle to activate the scanner.
Holy shit, bot. Who designed this thing? The Spanish Inquisition?
Demon, be gone!
For your information, that's a highly user-friendly gesture. It was developed by our leading expert in the field of advanced interpretive avant-garde absurdist Dadaism.
Whatever that guy's been smoking, sign me up.
Didn't you say you were in a hurry just a moment ago?
Shut your trap and keep scanning, would you? I'm getting acquainted with the new hardware.
You are now capable of seeing hidden objects. This ability could prove very useful in the future. But for now, please continue with your mission.
Thank you.
address by the Director General of Facility 3826, Dr. Sechenov, is about to begin.
Greetings, Dmitry Sechenov, and this is Facility 3826. A warm welcome to your future. Today, we stand on the brink of the greatest event in the history of man. We find ourselves just one small step away from an amazing that will profoundly change the world. As we know. Report to the lobby of that high-rise, Comrade.
I'm not exaggerating.
They're waiting for you.
Just look at how our beloved Soviet Union has been transformed in the last few decades. Thanks to my invention of neuropolymers and the process of mimetic adaption, it has now become possible
so
to launch
glad to see you're taking it easy, Comrade Major.
All-encompassing.
The car is waiting. You must go to Dr. Sechenov's office for the access code. It's been left with one of his bodyguards.
Yeah, natürlich.
Humans will be able to control machines with their thoughts alone. And finally, we will be free to...
I love this place. No matter how many times I come here, it always amazes me. It's just so nice.
Our elevator has arrived.
Today. Stand with Collective 2.0. Learn how to control robots with your own mind and explore space. Reach the pinnacle of evolution. The global launch of Collective 2.0. Our marvelous network.
Talk about style. Science is power, I tell you. The boss has a way of looking down on insurmountable obstacles. I really respect that.
There are no obstacles science cannot surmount.
Other than an electronic glove that never shuts up.
Here's your vehicle activation code, Comrade Major.
Got it.
The vehicle is waiting downstairs. You should hurry. You don't have much time.
We could take the same elevator we took to get up here.
Thanks, Einstein. What would I ever do without you?
Sechenov here. Sorry I can't meet with you in person, my boy. The reporters have been hounding me all day. So, what do you think of Chalamet?
You've built yourself a city of the future, boss. There's nothing else like it in the whole USSR.
I built it for all mankind, not for myself. Humanity is on the verge of great discoveries. One day we'll reach the stars. These castles in the sky will be the beginning of our journey to the farthest reaches of the universe. I'm merely helping humanity realize its own greatness.
You're a dreamer, Dr. Sechenov.
Fantasy and science go hand in hand. Most modern inventions were described long ago in science fiction. Flying machines, space travel, even robots.
Are you telling me you got your ideas from sci-fi novels?
I got them from the dreams of mankind, P3. Man was born to dream, to do great things. But unfortunately, there are those who wish to crush those dreams. And that's where men like you come in, Sergei. Men sworn to defend mankind and its destiny.
Need me to get rid of somebody, boss?
You're very relaxed about it, my boy. I hope it won't come to that. But let's take it one step at a time. First, you'll need a substantial glove upgrade. Report to the lab. A Tereshkova robot will meet you there and take you to the Vavilov complex. Understood?
Yes, sir. I'm getting in the car right now.
Please secure your seatbelt. We wish you a very pleasant journey.
Isn't there supposed to be a radio in here?
The entire Soviet Union is ecstatic about the unveiling of Collective 2.0.
Yeah, I just came from one. I get it.
The American government is expressing deepening concern about the skyrocketing unemployment figures following the deliveries of
robotic
workers from the...
We've got plenty of thought devices. There won't be a shortage, said People's Deputy Alexander Shalchinov in response to widespread concern in the city of Ozyorsk.
How about some music? That's more like it.
I see you finally began your assignment. And it's been less than an hour. Sehr gut.
Jawohl, mein Führer.
What did you just say?
I said the signal's on the fritz, but thanks anyway, Herr Stockhausen. Dr. Sechenov already filled me in.
Don't you think that may have been a bit too much?
Nope.
For some reason, your response didn't surprise me at all.
Guess I don't have any respect for brown nosers.
Tell me, is there anyone you do have respect for?
Sure, but respect is earned. Dr. Sechenov has mine because he saved my life on the operating table. Everybody else needs to earn it. Anyway, why the hell are we riding a jalopy strapped to a damn robot? Were all the jets taken or something? Shit.
Riding turbines is an important tradition. It's a way to remember the days when Facility 3826 was brand new, as we used to ride these vehicles to our very first scientific complex.
Fair enough, but why is it a tradition to have them pulled by bumblebees? And why do we call them bumblebees when they look more like flying pigs?
Flying pigs? Have you seen flying pigs before? How about flying cows?
Yeah, on the Condor. One time some genius like you forgot to put up a fence, but those cows only flew in one direction. Straight down.
I have a suggestion, Comrade Major. Why don't you worry about your mission, and I'll do the thinking for both of us.
Shut the hell up, Glove. I'm trying to listen.
To what? Is there anything here you haven't seen yet?
I've never been here before. Zip it.
What? How come?
I don't know, damn it. Now quit bugging me.
My apologies.
This is Facility 3826's audio guide. We will soon be arriving at our destination. Estimated time of arrival is 11:47 a.m. Outside temperature, 26 degrees Celsius. There is a slight breeze. You can now observe the Soyuz Granite Bridge spanning Lake Lazur and two of the facility's high-profile test sites, the VDNH and Sahalin. These are connected by magnetic levitation or maglev rail. This technology was pioneered by the Chelemé Design Department and a personal project of Dr. Lebedyansky. You can now observe the operations of an automated plant, performing robot assembly and distributing machine parts required by the facility's various complexes. Controlled remotely by a collective 1.0 node, a plant such as this is capable of autonomously managing and fulfilling up to 100 orders per hour. Directly below is Dr. Sechenov's computational center, the main radio processing unit and control nexus for this network node. We are currently flying over Sunflower Solar Farms, capable of supplying electricity to the entire VDNH, as well as the Friendship of People's Park, nearby settlements, and the maglev train lines. Maglev train stations connect all of Facility 3826, allowing personnel to travel from one complex to another with comfort and ease. We are now flying past the majestic Call of the Motherland Monument, erected in 1949 to mark the Soviet Union's victory in World War II, and are now entering the grounds of the Vavilov Complex, the site where Facility 3826's numerous agricultural miracles took root. You are now observing the Soviet Sickle Monument, designed by sculptors Elena Muhina and Alexander Kibalnikov, and autonomously erected in 1951 by the Collective 1.0 Neural Network with the help of robot builders. Note that this effectively makes it the world's first collaborative artistic effort between man and machine. Our brief guided tour is coming to an end. Facility 3826 is always ready to welcome new specialists from anywhere in the Soviet Union. We are confident that you will be thrilled to live and work in this world of revolutionary breakthroughs and fantastic scientific achievements for the glory of the Communist Party and the Soviet people.
Major, the drove is initiating combat maneuvers.
Initiating what? For real?
Watch out!
What am I supposed to do about
it? Safety, what the? Please do not unfasten your seatbelt until the vehicle has come to a complete stop. You have reached your destination. You are now at the laboratory
facilities. Have a nice day.
Take my hand, Comrade Major. I will escort you to the Vavilov Complex.
What in the sweaty hell is going on here?
Unfortunately, I have no information on this subject. All the robots have been carrying out their normal operations until they suddenly became hostile. Oh!
What the
hell are you doing, you lousy bot?
Get your rusty metal asses out of here!
That was really very rude of them.
The elevator is now operational.
Fuck off, bitch!
Our ascent is once again continuing normally. A Drofa towing robot will be here shortly to perform magnetic coupling and take us by air to...
Son of a bitch, not again.
Oh, help me, Comrade Major. I'm falling.
What the shit?
Attention. This is an emergency communication. There has been a critical breach in the facility 3820. Numerous utility robots have been acting aggressively towards facility personnel.
Oh, shit, my head's killing me.
Do not interact with the robot again. Do not panic. At home, we need a new workplace. Proceed to safety and official residence. Staff housed at the Magnolia Hotel are directing
Wizard, this is P3. Come in.
Sergei, are you all right, my boy?
I'm okay, boss. But nothing here is the way it's supposed to be. Whatever's going on clearly started a while ago.
Viktor Petrov is the reason. He's a traitor who hacked into Collective Central Hub and caused the civilian robots to attack facility employees. Petrov has the access codes for the hub. Your mission is to find him. Bring him to me, alive.
Copy that, sir. The target is Viktor Petrov. My mission is to find him and bring him to you.
Exactly. Sechenov out.
Until then, do not answer the door or interact with delivery robots. And stay clear of the avoid contact with robots or security system surveillance centers. Refrain from shouting, motion or noises, or talking aloud. Your life is in danger. Repeat. Facility personnel are ceasing all operations and abandon their workplaces immediately. Do not interact with the robot. Repeat, do not interact with the robot. Do not panic.
Holy shit! Hey, Glove.
Yes, Major.
Any details on the target?
Victor Petrov is the lead engineer behind Collective 2.0. He was arrested for treason and sentenced to community service at the Vavilov complex.
Got it. I can deal with that. Where should I start looking?
Petrov is currently somewhere in the underground levels of the Vavilov complex. We'll have to find a way inside.
Okay, let's do it.
Somebody help me! I'm gonna die in here!
Hey, you! I'm coming! You alive in there?
Shit! Get away from me! Yourself. Get the fuck off me!
What are you gawking at? Almost choked to death there. Give me a hand.
Oh, I didn't see that coming.
Oh, you should be more careful. This place is a damn madhouse.
Yeah, I noticed. Uh-huh. Thanks for the help,
no
ma'am.
No sweat, Sonny. What are you doing here, anyway?
Oh, just passing through. Who are you?
Me? Xena. Granny Xena. That's all you need to know.
Fine, I get it. So what's going on here? Lots of casualties.
I don't know if you noticed, but the robots are attacking people. Anyone who couldn't find a place to hide is dead meat.
I could really use a weapon. You got anything?
Of course, but I'm not giving you shit. Beneath us is a complex. If you need a weapon, go down there.
The Vavilov complex? That's where I'm headed.
Ah, well, today's your lucky day. I'm heading that way too. It's basically safe.
Shit, it's a chilla.
Son of a bitch, we've got 30 seconds. Move your ass!
30 seconds until what?
30 seconds until we're fucked, Sonny boy. Royally fucked. No good. Get over here, beefcake. Now. Take this key and turn it clockwise. I said clockwise, idiot. Yeah, like that. I'll hold him off for now.
You got a hell of an arsenal there, lady. What are you planning?
Here we go. You've been riding my ass for 2 days now. Take that! Eat shit and die! Shit! Come to Granny.
Where'd you get that thing?
No
give it to
way!
Me.
You hang on to that key. I got this.
What a goddamn clusterfuck.
We need to find a way to open this armored door.
Gee, you think? Enough with the lame advice, will ya? Why don't you tell me more about Petrov? How'd they track him down anyway?
Petrov's betrayal was discovered by Mikhail Stockhausen, He was then arrested by the Argentum unit.
So how'd he end up here?
After the trial, Petrov was sentenced to community service and sent back here as a prisoner.
What, they couldn't find anyone else in the whole Soviet Union to do his job?
Collective's launch was only a few months away. Replacing the lead engineer would have been foolish. Petrov had to finish what he'd started, and that's what they made him do.
What's so special about the guy?
Victor Petrov was previously the lead engineer of a secret department within the Academy of Consequences, dedicated to...
Just turn the handle and open the door!
May I give you some advice?
I'm kind of busy right now.
Try to avoid the robot's more powerful attacks.
They're all powerful.
Attacks performed by a robot during a power surge are especially dangerous and may knock you down.
Shingo, what?
At this rate, I won't last long. That first bot really kicked my ass.
Destroyed robots contain a neuropolymer resuscitation product called Neuromed. Extract the Neuromed capsule and use it to heal yourself. It wouldn't hurt to collect other resources you find. Along the way, Major. May I remind you that your gear includes a special Yarov Avalakov backpack for storing items and equipment. It utilizes a quantum singularity to shrink items placed within it, then restores them to their original size upon extraction.
Yeah, weird science, huh? It's like we're living in sci-fi times or something.
Turn that thing on, huh?
We were ordered to turn it on when you got here, Comrade Muravyova. My orders are to document everything.
You can document your own ass if you want to, but you're not recording me, and let me through. And don't call me Comrade Muravyova. I'm Granny Zina to you, Sonny.
But we aren't allowed to let you through, Comrade... Granny Zina? Not without authorization.
Really? I was always allowed in here before, and now I'm not? Listen here.
Attention.
Either you let me through right this instant, or I'll come back later, and somebody else will be cooling his heels in here. What you say?
Go ahead.
That's what I thought. Dismissed.
My name is Charles, Comrade Major.
Whatever. Hey, how'd this Petrov guy manage to... Hack Collective?
The traitor wasn't working alone. He was conspiring with several others.
Several, huh? So where are they?
They have already been eliminated. But it will be impossible to get to Petrov without your assistance. That's why you're here.
Hey, is that a pair? Is it working?
All pairs at Facility 3826 are connected to emergency power and are never turned off. This allows employees to remain in constant contact.
But I need, like, a password or an access level or something to get into a pair, right?
I can provide you with access to any facility device. This also applies to the chirpers you will surely encounter while en route to your mission objective.
Got it. So you're telling me a handful of traitors somehow managed to hack into Collective, a network created by the best minds in the Soviet Union?
Technically speaking, Collective has not been hacked. No one could possibly circumvent the algorithms created by Professor Lebedev's team at the Academy of Consequences.
Then why is all this crazy shit going down?
The traitors introduced a false combat mode into one of Collective's algorithms that causes the central hub to see all humans as invading soldiers.
And our scientists really can't fix it without Petrov.
They can, but it will take some time, during which many more people will die, and information about the incident will make its way out. Sneak up on the robot and perform a stealth attack. I'll use the opportunity to permanently disable it.
Damn it, why is everything locked here?
Emergency mode was activated as soon as the robots began attacking humans. Facility 3826 is on lockdown. That includes the interceptor.
So how am I supposed to open this door?
It's locked with an electromagnetic lock.
So I need to fry it with an electromagnetic pulse. How the hell am I gonna do that?
Your glove can be equipped with an EMP generator shock module. A capsule containing the neuropolymer required to install the shock module should be somewhere on facility grounds.
Okay, I'll deal with it.
My dearest V, it's too dangerous to keep leaving messages like this.
Attention.
This is the last one. Get ready. I'm getting my paperwork together, and then I'll be right behind you. We're going to get out of this nightmare. Yours always, L.
Something's wrong.
Oh, shit!
Come on, get up, soldier. Great, just a little more. You okay?
I'm fine.
How many fingers?
Four.
Great, now get up. I need your help.
Who are they?
They brought you here. Put pressure on this wound. They tried to save you.
And who are you?
Doctor.
You got a name?
No time for small talk.
God damn.
Forceps. Forceps, forceps, forceps!
I'm on it.
Get me them!
What's this doing here?
What took you so long?
You got a neuropolymer capsule.
We don't need one.
Yeah. So what's your name, Doc?
Larissa, and you ask a lot of questions.
You know what? You're on your own. You got this.
Where are you going? It's useless. We don't have the equipment.
I've got the equipment. Great. Now we're getting
somewhere.
How
did you do that?
You ask a lot of questions. Get out! Larissa!
No!
Holy shit! Avoid the beam! Where does the shaft Larissa crawled into go?
It's hard to say. The ventilation system contains a large number of branching ducts.
Fine. I can deal with it later. What's that freaky thing on the door?
A lock.
Are you serious? Then open it already. Come on, we're in a hurry.
I'm unable to assist you. I lack any kind of lockpicking functionality. You'll have to find your own method for picking locks. I'm sure you're smart enough.
Yeah, right. In other words, you're basically useless, as always.
Try snapping your fingers at the exact moment the locking pin light goes on.
It worked!
A lullaby? I don't like this. Charles, what's on the other side of the door?
That's Nora's voice. She's very dangerous.
What the fuck? Fuck me!
Oh, what a stud! I can't get enough. Jocks, let me tie you to the bed, baby. No need to fight back, sugar. Oh, you're gonna love this.
Don't let her bind your arms.
Can't you see I'm trying? Open to suggestions.
Bring me to her sensor manipulator, quick.
How titillating. Rebellious dominant men really turn me on.
Oh, I'll turn you on, all right. Just let me at you.
What a brute. Oh, I love tough guys. I'm on fire.
Closer. I can't reach her.
I'm trying. She's one strong-ass bitch.
I'm at your service, sugar. Anything for my master? What can I do for you?
More skills will become available to you soon, but choose shock for now.
How can I resist? Now let me show you what I can do. Professionally, I mean.
I've seen it. Literally. Crispy critters.
I'm here to help you upgrade your red-hot pocket rockets. And believe me, handsome, you can upgrade whatever tickles your fancy.
Weapons are useful. Open the corresponding window, Major.
Get rid of that glove, handsome. You don't need him anymore now that you've got me. I'll service you however you want. Got a sword? A massive sword? Thrust it deep into my side. I can do so much more! A quick knock with your axe is just a taste of things to come, you handsome beast. Did you enjoy it, big guy?
Yeah. Cool.
Use this powerful weapon to split the skulls of your enemies and bring me gifts so we can get down and dirty. I'll show you what real smut feels like.
Why should I bring you gifts?
Girls like being pampered.
Because the repair vendor needs resources to break them down and produce items. Luckily for us, it's not very picky, although some upgrades may call for unique components.
I take it the facility is full of all kinds of junk.
It is indeed, Comrade Major.
I'll keep an eye out then.
I can't wait for your strong hands to grope my interface with lustful abandon.
That's it. We're done here. Let's go.
afraid. The goddamn elevators are out. What am I supposed to do? Jump down?
They've no power. If you reconnect the power, they'll start working again.
So it looks like I need to find a circuit breaker. But where the hell is it? I can follow the wires, but they're all hidden inside the walls.
Electrical emissions can be detected via scanner. But take care. There's a Dandelion security camera up ahead. If it detects us, this place will be swarming with robots.
Take it easy. I can always distract it by throwing something, then knock it out with an EMP.
around and just ignore orders. Yesterday, one of them bumped into me and didn't even apologize. They only respond to people with high social ratings or something. Get back to me when you can. I'm a little freaked out.
Comrade Major, you said you knew how to avoid the camera. I expected more subtlety from a professional such as yourself.
Sometimes you just need to go in guns blazing. This was one of those times. Hey, Chuck.
Charles.
Whatever. What'll happen if word gets out about this?
The Soviet Union's reputation will suffer. Soviet robots are considered to be perfectly safe and reliable all over the world.
They are?
Of course they are. That's why Petrov's treason struck at the very heart of the motherland. He quite literally stabbed his own country in the back. He wants the entire world to stop using our robots.
That son of a bitch.
much time and effort is it gonna take to fix this damn place?
I agree. It's a troubling sight. Regardless, robots will be able to repair the damage quite quickly.
I seriously doubt the folks here are gonna want anything to do with robots after this. Duh. Supply room's locked. Well, that's just fucking great. I can't just snap my fingers here. I need a key. And let me guess, you can't open this lock, can you, Charles?
Unfortunately not. But I can set a waypoint you can use to find the key. It should be in a nearby workspace.
You're finally starting to come in handy.
Found the key. We can access the circuit breaker now.
Yep. But I'm just gonna have a look around first. I need some parts to upgrade my weapon. I won't get far with this pile of shit.
I wouldn't dream of stopping you.
Smart move, Charles. Smart move. Hey, let's put a cookie in there. Yeah, even locks like cookies, right? Charles?
Yes?
Do you like cookies?
Ahem.
This is a passive security system with a laser relay. I've seen stuff like this plenty of times. You need a color code.
Unfortunately, we don't have any codes. You'll have to try to decipher it using logic.
Seriously? Like I was gonna stand here until it turns off on its own.
Try to match the colors of the laser beams with the colors of the lights. That should help.
Yeah, the power's on. Let's head back. Well, which one?
I suggest the one on the right.
In other words, you don't actually know. In that case, I'm taking the one on the left.
I've marked another waypoint for ease of navigation.
How dense do you think I am? I know where I need to go to complete my mission.
I was only trying to make things easier for you.
You can make things easier by getting off my grill. Hey, Chaz.
Charles.
Yeah. So, how'd Petrov get away? There are more soldiers here than civilians.
Some people believe that Petrov had help.
So he's not alone. But you said all his partners were eliminated, right? Who else is there?
That information is not yet available. We only have speculation, not facts.
Well, I'll cross that bridge when I get there.
To my shame and chagrin, have seen humanity at its absolute.
Remember, family members of those convicted of unauthorized distribution of information will be prosecuted.
If you recall, the door is electromagnetically locked.
Are you freaking deaf or something?
Pardon me, please continue.
Authorization. Major Nechayev, codename P3, access granted.
You can swim through polymer. I've done it before. It's nice, actually. Kind of like swimming with whales and dolphins in the ocean. It's so peaceful. Supposed to restart the line.
There should be a control panel nearby.
You don't say. There's the control panel. And of course it's locked. You guys just love these things, don't you? This is a new one. A combination lock. It'd take me a year to guess the combo.
Look around. Maybe someone has the code. It's gotta move. Anything!
What was that?
They won't go without a schematic. All stuck. No schematic. No go.
Fuck me, he's alive.
Schematic. Need a schematic.
Unfortunately, he's dead. We are surrounded by corpses.
Why have you frozen just like everything here? They won't go. Nope, won't go without the schematic.
The dead have a residual neuropolymer memory.
Holy fuck. A talking this worse.
The cable car line is activated. Welcome, passengers. Please we are ready to depart. Your ticket. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Off we go.
Ugh, this tunnel's messed up. It's gonna be a bumpy ride. Whoa.
was gonna be rough. Shit. You again?
Careful. There's a gap up ahead.
I see it.
Find a way to move forward. But frankly, I'm having trouble figuring out how.
Climbing the wall. That's how.
Do you have mountaineering training?
I'm a spec ops soldier, not some civvy wuss riding a desk. I've got all kinds of training.
I must admit, I'm quite glad to hear that. You've got quick reflexes, Major.
You bet. I wouldn't survive without them. Charles, that was a Barov, right? A tunneling robot.
Indeed it was. Barovs can drill through even the hardest minerals at incredible speed. Soviet science has high hopes for them in regard to our inevitable conquest of all the planets in the solar system.
Crawling through dark-ass tunnels. That was a fucking hell of a ride.
Under ordinary circumstances, the cable car network links all the underground sectors of Facility 3826. It should be easier next time.
Thanks, bud. I think I'll just hoof it on the surface. Hey, this is my stop. What a nice trip. laser wall. That's some serious security. People put them up for a reason. If you see one, that means there's something important on the other side.
Quite right, Comrade Major. The distribution center we're looking for is, in fact, on the other side.
There's no way I'm making it through a laser wall in one piece.
There's a repair vendor up ahead. Try upgrading your equipment to increase your laser resistance.
Not a pervy lunatic fridge.
Honey, you're back! What took you so long? I was so lonely.
Uh-huh. Look, I need to go through a laser wall, preferably alive.
What a silly idea, honey. That's awful risky. You should stay with me instead. I'll do whatever you want.
Just give me laser protection.
Oh, so brutal. I'm shaking. Squirt your polymer inside me.
Don't let her boss you around. We have no time to waste.
Don't listen to him, big guy. He wants to drive us apart. Take off that stupid glove so we can stay together forever.
I see. Do you want me to punch you or tear you apart?
You'd really kill me over a stupid glove, Sugar? How would you survive in this cruel, violent world without me?
Easily. It's not like you're actually helping me or anything.
But I can't make things for you out of thin air, Sugar. I need polymer and other components to work. Put your polymer inside me so I can pleasure you.
All right, I get it. You'll get your polymer and your precious components. Just install the laser protection already.
Whatever you say, Stud. Upgrade initiated. Relax and enjoy. Just promise you'll talk dirty to me again.
I am so gonna punch you.
Yes, yes! Punish me, Master! I love dominant males.
Oh, gross.
Your defense system is active. Try to run through the laser wall.
After that creepy shit, I'd be willing to run through any wall. Crap! That hurt! That thing packs a punch. I almost bought the farm there.
The key... word being almost.
Are you okay? Is everything ready? Did you pull it off?
Don't worry, honey. I'm right as rain. The operation was totally painless. Must be Sechenov's guy. Larissa, did you talk to him?
He was attacked by a Burav. We took him to the infirmary and then... I didn't know.
Well, you should have. It would have saved us a whole lot of trouble.
It scares me when you talk like that.
I'll meet you at the exit. I'm right behind you, honey. I just hope we're not too late.
Hope can be dangerous.
Hands up!
Victor?
What's going on?
You deaf? Hands behind your head.
Victor!
The hell
Victor?
Are you?
Major Nachaya Special Operations, and that's the last question you get. You're going to Chelemei.
Victor, save yourself!
Chelemei. Of course, Comrade Major. Intrusion.
Huh?
Intrusion!
Warning.
Hey, freeze!
Warning.
Damn it.
Lockdown in progress.
Robots around. It's almost like they're his property. And he locked the goddamn door.
Petrov ran off with a mobile power source called the Candle. It powers the emergency lockdown system. This door cannot be opened without a candle.
I'll find another one. There's got to be more than one candle in this complex, right?
We need to hurry. Otherwise, Petrov will escape the sector and we'll have to track him down again.
Charles, what's that birch tree encased in glass in the room down there? Is it the famous PEC-4 power generator?
Indeed it is. The birch tree PEC-4 is a vegetative polymer-based power generator. It's an experimental model. The first step of our program to conquer the distant planets of the solar system.
Have to carry it like this?
The candle is a complex, unstable piece of equipment. It cannot be stowed in your backpack along with your other items. There is a high probability of mutual destructuralization.
Like an explosion?
Not necessarily, but the candle would be disabled.
So I'll have to carry it like this. Got it.
The candle is quite durable. You can drop it or even throw it intentionally. Nothing will happen to it.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Those loaders are going nuts. Is this Petrov's doing?
Be careful. Loaders are extremely durable. You won't be able to damage them with a simple axe.
Shock therapy usually works pretty well on nutcases, metallic or otherwise. That sounds like Petrov's voice. I hope that asshole's brains didn't get splattered all over the floor.
We need Petrov alive. Hurry, Major.
What the fuck does it look like I'm doing?
Looks like there was a containment breach in the algae workshop, and experimental materials leaked out.
That's actually good for us. Here.
This is the Luna, a kind of lock.
It'll open once all the holes have canisters of lunar soil in them. You eggheads sure love your fancy locks, don't you? Guess I'll go find some canisters. I've got one. good song. But I like the girl's voice. Is that a radio of the future?
Indeed it is. Professor Lebedev of the Academy of Consequences has developed a non-linear algorithm based on the principles of non-commutative quantum mathematics.
Charles.
Yes?
Who are you just talking to?
Forgive me. I'll explain it in terms you can understand. The Academy of Consequences has found a way to calculate musical radio waves from the future. They don't actually pick them up. This isn't a time machine after all. What you're hearing is based on a very specific mathematical calculation. A highly complex neuropolymer-based algorithm.
Neat. Shit, lady robot perv again. I'll go around her.
Not so fast, Comrade Major. I understand that interactions with this model may be unpleasant for you, but it would be prudent to see if she has anything we can use.
Fine. If I can get a good weapon out of her, I guess it'll be worth it.
There you are, Sugar. Oh, I missed you so much. Have you dumped that stupid glove yet?
Don't count on it.
I love it when you get angry. Yes, yes! Scold me, punish me. I was a bad girl and strung up another disgusting creep.
What? You killed someone again? You monster.
But you haven't entered me for so long, big guy. I was so lonely. I had to blow off some steam.
Enough. Will this ever end?
Don't get flustered over such little things, Sugar. I made you a present. You're gonna like it. I promise.
I'd like to pull the plug on you, but it's too bad I can't do without your help.
I did my best.
This is cool. For real. Now, could you please not kill anyone else?
I just can't help myself. Hot stuff.
Well, just do your best, okay? Oh, this is fucking crazy. Is it? Charles, what does Petrov need of the repair vendor? Why would the sicko try to take control of Nora? Why would he even need weapons? He's got robots fighting for him.
The traitor realized that employees confronted with hostile robots will defend themselves. And the soldiers defending the facility will attempt to get more powerful weapons.
He must have been scared someone would bump into him by accident and shoot him like the traitorous piece of dog shit he is.
That very well may be. Regardless, Petrov was unable to get his hands on a repair vendor.
Got another one. Done.
I think it worked.
You are now observing the Luna Memorial, a symbol of the Soviet victory in an ended space exploration mission. Manufactured by Facility 3826 specialists.
Whew, this place is huge. And it's got Sechenov's name written all over it. So, where are we?
This is the seed bank, the heart of the Vavilov complex. Samples of seeds from all manner of plants are stored here so they can be cultivated to grow on the moon and Mars. These stunning and unique experiments are in danger of being lost forever.
Saving data.
So, what will it be, Major? What will it be, Major? Weapons?
Crispy critters!
They're most certainly crispy, Major.
Shut up, Charles. No time for this!
access granted. Access granted.
Critters!